What's up, dudes, and what's up, ladies? Bryan here, and in this video, we're going to look at citric acid. What is it, where does it come from, and how it can affect our health. So, let's roll! Citric acid is an acid that occurs naturally in citrus fruits. Lemons and limes have higher concentrations, sometimes as much as 8% of their dry weight. Other fruits, such as oranges and grapefruits, contain citric acid, but at much lower concentrations. However, there is a much less expensive way to produce the acid, and the demand for citric acid far outweighs the supply of citrus fruits available. The way most citric acid is made is by cultivating a mold called Aspergillus niger, which causes a disease called black mold on certain fruits and vegetables. Aspergillus niger is fed sucrose or glucose, which is sugar, and then processing the resulting fermented compound to yield citric acid. Most citric acid is used in foods and beverages as it provides a tart, citrus taste and acts as a preservative. Because of its acidic pH, many bacteria are unable to grow in its environment. It's also found in soaps and detergents because of its ability to soften water. And many cosmetics use it as a preservative as it helps adjust the acid-base balance. So, is citric acid harmful or unhealthy? Aspergillus niger fermentation is generally recognized as safe. The main concern with citric acid is, does it come from GMOs as a starting material? There are genetically modified versions of the Aspergillus niger mold, as well as genetically modified sugar beets. Some companies are producing non-GMO versions, though. The most harmful effect seems to be that of overexposure to citric acid can erode tooth enamel, leading to decay. It's hard to imagine that anyone can eat enough citrus fruits to cause this, but drinking and eating a lot of products that contain the acid could take its toll. Other symptoms may include stomach ache, diarrhea, and nausea. Bottom line time. Again, folks, it's always about moderation. It's probably impossible to completely avoid this ingredient. Just increase your awareness by reading ingredient labels and gauge how much of it you're consuming. Oh, and make sure you brush your teeth. All right. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. If you feel I have wasted a few minutes of your time, I apologize. You can hit the thumbs down and give me instant revenge. Till next time, I'm out. See ya.